Hello and welcome everyone, Andy Bryan here again from the Soul Pathway. And today within this video, I wanted to speak with you about spirituality and walking the Red Road. Now the Red Road goes back to Native American teachings and the Lakota tribe. And for them, it's a way of life and a way of being. And today within this video, we are going to be speaking about that with relation to our own spiritual journey and our soul pathway. So what is the Red Road? For me, the Red Road is noticing the interconnectedness with one and everything and everyone that walks our path. It's noticing our connection with Great Spirit and also Mother Earth. And noticing that everyone that walks our path brings us a deeper sense of meaning, purpose, and could bring us great wisdom to support us on our journey. It's also noticing that no one is either above or below us. We are all equal in this journey of life. For me, walking the Red Road is all about living your purpose and your truth. Being guided by that every single day, being guided by Great Spirit and the animals that roam the planet with us, being guided by others that walk our path, and noticing that we are never alone when we are walking our spiritual journey. We always have our spiritual tribe with us. And so walking the Red Road is living from that deeper sense of purpose and meaning, and living from a place of unconditional love for not only ourselves, but everyone that walks our path. For me, it's that deeper sense of connectedness as well. Knowing that we are connected to one and everything brings us a great sense of peace, unity and harmony with one and all. And I think that is very, very important, because the natives also speak about the Black Road. And the Black Road is the road that is paved for them already. And the Black Road is riddled with people that have gone through depression, people that have experienced drug abuse, alcoholism, and feel very much disconnected from themselves and the world around them. So walking the Black Road is very much being so very much connected to society and being given a pathway for you at which you can lead, and not noticing who you are and your purpose and meaning for living, you know. So walking the Red Road is leading off that path at which you know, that Black Road at which has been paved before you, and walking the Red Road where you're connected with those beautiful red rocks, and whereby you put your feet on the ground and you connect with the beautiful Mother Earth, noticing that you are connected with Mother Earth. And Mother Earth is nurturing and supporting you in each and every moment. So for me, walking the Red Road is incredibly beautiful. But it's a journey, and the journey is the destination. And this is where my soul pathway process comes in. Because we start living by our old selves when we are walking that Black Road. Because that's all we know in many ways. We have that soul awakening, and then we start to connect with that deeper meaning and purpose for our lives. And then we begin following our own Red Road that brings us that deep sense of purpose and fulfillment in our lives. So I think this is absolutely beautiful. But within this video, I wanted to also share the 7 Ojibway teachings and the principles that they live by, because I think they are absolutely beautiful, and I'm sure you will connect with them too. for me, this helps to bring meaning of what it means to walk the red road. So let me move over to share my screen and speak about the seven Ojibway teachings and the shamanic principles we can all live by. So these come from the beautiful spirit animals which we connect with on each and every day. The first principle is respect, which is learned from the buffalo. To know respect is really to know how to give. Buffalo giving themselves so that people can survive, to know and recognize how important respect truly is. And we all know the importance of the buffalo to the natives. Many years ago, they provided, you know, the coats at which they wear to keep them warm. You know, they provided the meat to nourish them every single day. And even the bones we used for children as toys. So we give respect to the buffalo, and that is where obviously the respect comes from. Then we move on to love. Love is symbolized by the eagle. It has always been understood that the essence and spirit in each and every one of us carries the energy and spirit of love. We were created through the unconditional love of Great Spirit. The three most powerful words that can be said are, "I love you." The moment you begin to say that, something happens inside of you. The spirit inside of your heart, what love represents, life. That is absolutely beautiful. And when it comes to our spiritual journey, love is essential. It's all about raising that consciousness and awareness, stepping away from those conditions and patterns of which you thought were right and true for you. Moving away from those conditions you placed upon love to embrace unconditional love of, again, one and everything. So that is beautiful from Eagle Medicine. And we look at the courage. The bear brings courage. You have got to have courage to do the right thing. There are many ways to do the wrong thing, but only one way to do the right thing. And that is expressed from the heart. This takes a lot of courage. Help me have the courage to do the right thing. Again, that is very, very beautiful. Beautiful from the bear there. And when we live our purpose, we connect with that at which we love. And this gives off a vibration and allows others to walk that path with us, as they connect with that beautiful unconditional love and the courage in their heart. So let's now move to honesty. Honesty expressed through Bigfoot. Honesty meant that you learn to speak from your heart. Learn to speak from your heart and get out of your head, is what I always say. Your mind is in many ways going to lead you in the opposite way of what your heart is trying to express. To be honest is to be true to your word. Sabe was always there to offer inspiration in being honesty. And I would say honesty is always the best policy, and I know that may sound cliche, but it's essential. If we can be honest and truthful with ourselves, then we can live in integrity, live connected with our soul, and really support others in doing the same as well. So for me, that honesty expressed through Bigfoot is absolutely beautiful as well. Then we move down to wisdom. Wisdom represented by the beaver. To know wisdom is to know that you have a gift. Beaver teaches us too, if we want to build a better life, then we have to use the gifts that have been given to us. To know your wisdom is to once know your gift, so that you can use that to serve others, to serve your family, and to serve your community. And if you look at the spirit animal of the beaver has that tail, which is very unique. That tail is the special gift that they have. And on our spiritual journey, what we do is, as we move away from those old things that no longer serve us, we start to uncover who we truly are. And when we do that, we uncover the gifts and talents that are within us. And that is when we can give back in our own unique ways to serve those around us. So that is absolutely beautiful from the beaver there, connecting with your wisdom and your divine gifts. So let's move on. Humility. Humility is taught by the wolf. The wolf was there to remind us to live a humble life. To live a humble life is to acknowledge that there is a higher power of spirit. When you walk down a trail and the wolf is walking the same path, the first thing the wolf is going to do is stop and bow his head. Not because he is scared of you, but because he is humbled by the presence of the human being. To know humbleness is to think of your fellow human being before you think for yourself. Now, being humble, we know how much being humble is essential for us on our journey. Again, when we go on our journey and our spiritual journey, we, in essence, in many ways, looking at Joseph Campbell's work and the hero's journey, we become heroes in our own lives, and we can, you know, have this ego about us where we think we are better than others. But humbleness brings us down to earth, knowing that we are all, you know, on this journey together, and everyone walks their own path. And we've got to have compassion for everyone that walks it, knowing that they're on their own journey and they have their own pain. They have their own challenges and obstacles. We have to be humble enough to know that we have our own as well. And we also have, we also make mistakes, and knowing that when we make mistakes, we can fix them. So that's also about being humble within ourselves, which is again very beautiful. Then we look down finally to the seventh principle, which is all about truth. Turtle speaks about truth. We cannot learn truth until we are able to live the teachings as they have been passed on to us. The turtle is leaving a trail for us to follow. The turtle is carrying the teachings of respect, love, courage, honesty, wisdom, and humility, and connecting with the richness in the knowledge and wisdom that we all have. They are absolutely beautiful. I absolutely love those principles, and I believe if we all live by those principles, we can truly create a beautiful and remarkable world. It's just allowing us to connect with those things. So now I wanted to share a poem with you about what it means to walk the red road. This is a poem I found online, and I hope that it can help you, you know, deepen your meaning to what it means to walk the red road. But let me share that with you now. The long road, winding, began in the stars, spilled onto mountain tops, was carried in the snow to the streams, to the rivers, to the oceans. It covers Canada, Alaska, America, Mexico to Guatemala, and keeps winding around the indigenous. The road is a circle of people standing hand in hand. People in this world, people between people in the spirit world, star people, animal people, stone people, river people, Free People, the Sacred Hoop. To walk the red road is to know sacrifice and suffering, is to understand humility. It is the ability to stand naked before God in all things, or your wrongdoings, or your lack of strength, or your uncompassionate ways, or your arrogance. Because to walk the red road, you always know that you can do better. And you know, when you do good things, it is through the Creator, and you are grateful. To walk the red road is to know that you stand on equal ground with all things. It is to know that because you were born human, it gives you superiority over nothing. It is to know that every creation carries a spirit, and every river knows more than you do. The mountains know more than you do. The stone people know more than you do. The trees know more than you do. The wind is wiser than you are. And people, animal people, carry great wisdom. You can learn from everyone because they have something that you don't. They are void of evil thoughts. They wish vengeance on no one. They seek justice. To walk the red road, you have God-given rights. You have the right to prayer. You have the right to dance. You have the right to think. You have the right to protect. You have the right to know mother. You have the right to dream. You have the right to vision. You have the right to teach. You have the right to learn. You have the right to grieve. You have the right to happiness. You have the right to fix the wrongs. And you have the right to truth. And you have the right to the spirit world. To walk the red road is to know your ancestors, to call upon them for assistance. It is to know that there is good medicine and there is bad medicine. It is to know that evil exists, but it's cowardly, as it is often in disguise. It is to know that there are evil spirits. You're in contrast, watch the way to gain strength for themselves at the expense of you. To walk the red road, you have less fear of being wrong, because you know that life is a journey, a continuous cycle, a sacred hoop. Mistakes will be made, and mistakes can be corrected. If you are humble, but you cannot be humble, you will never know when you have made a mistake. If you walk the red road, you know that every sorrow leads to better understanding. Every horror cannot be explained, but can offer growth. To walk the red road is to look for the beauty of all things. To walk the red road is to know you will one day cross the spirit world, and you will not be afraid. And these are beautiful teachings from Native American wisdom. So I do hope you've found this video to be valuable and useful. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them again in the comments section below. And if you would like any personal guidance and support on your spiritual journey and soul pathway to connect with your red road, then please be sure to reach out with me. And with that, I will say thank you very much for listening. Take care, much love, and I'll see you again on another video very soon. Bye for now.
If you would like any personal support on your spiritual journey or soul pathway, please be sure to visit my website, www.awakenyoursoulpathway.co.uk, where you can schedule your soul discovery session. And these sessions are designed as an introductory session where you can get to know me, I can get to know you, and you can really explore your soul as an individual as you awaken to who you are. So these are introductory sessions. They are priced at $22, and this is a non-refundable deposit to ensure that you are really interested in making those differences and changes in your life. So if you would like to schedule a session, please pop over to my website and schedule a session there and make a small payment. And with that, I will say thank you for listening, and I wish you all the best on your spiritual journey and soul pathway as you awaken to who you are. Thank you for listening, and I will speak to you again soon. Bye for now.